Wi-Fi extenders can be a great addition to your home network, but they do come with some limitations. In order to figure out if a Wi-Fi extender is a good fit for your home network, you need to understand what these limitations are and also if there are any ways around them. So let's take it from the top. What is a Wi-Fi extender? Well, a Wi-Fi extender does exactly what you think. It extends your Wi-Fi coverage in your home. It takes the Wi-Fi signal from your router and pushes it to new areas of your home that are existing dead spots. It's important to note here that your Wi-Fi extender does not replace your modem and router. You need to have those in place, but a Wi-Fi extender is an auxiliary device that helps you build upon your existing home network to expand your Wi-Fi coverage. To illustrate what I mean, let's look at an example. Here you have a modem and router. Your router is broadcasting a Wi-Fi signal. This Wi-Fi signal is indicated by this green highlighting. And as you can see, there's a dead zone in your home where the Wi-Fi signal from your router does not provide Wi-Fi coverage. Enter the Wi-Fi extender. In this case, we can implement a Wi-Fi extender in our home network. We can put it in this room. And as a result, you can see our Wi-Fi coverage gets expanded. So now the entire square footage of our home is covered. No matter where you're standing in your home, you can get a Wi-Fi signal to access the internet. It's important to note here that the Wi-Fi extender is put in a location where it receives a strong Wi-Fi signal from your router. You can't put your Wi-Fi extender out in the middle of nowhere where it can't communicate with your router, because essentially what it's doing is it's taking the Wi-Fi signal from your router and it's rebroadcasting it to other areas of your home. So what does a Wi-Fi extender look like? Well, Wi-Fi extenders come in many different shapes and sizes. Here's an example. This is a TP-Link AX3000 Wi-Fi extender. As you can see on the back of the device, it's made to connect to a power outlet. So what you do, you connect this device to a power outlet somewhere within range of your existing Wi-Fi network that's coming from your router. It then uses the antennas on the top of the device to receive that Wi-Fi broadcast from your router and then rebroadcast it out to other areas of your home. As you can see, there's not too much to these devices. They're fairly inexpensive. They're very easy to set up and configure as well. So it should be pretty easy to implement in your home network if you decide to get one. All right, so we've covered the basics here. So how does a Wi-Fi extender actually work? As I mentioned, these antennas are used to receive the Wi-Fi network from your router and then rebroadcast it out to different areas of your home. This is actually done on a separate Wi-Fi network. So this Wi-Fi extender will create another Wi-Fi network that your devices can communicate and connect with. So what happens is you can either make this Wi-Fi network name the same as the one that's broadcast from your router, or if you want to identify it uniquely, you can give it its own unique Wi-Fi network name. Then what happens is with this Wi-Fi network being broadcasted out to the dead zones of your home, your devices can then connect to that Wi-Fi network from this device. And then basically what happens is this Wi-Fi extender communicates with your router on behalf of your devices. To illustrate this, let's look at another example. First, we'll take a look at what an internet request looks like if there's no Wi-Fi extender in your home network. So it's pretty simple and straightforward. Say we make an internet request for a specific website with our laptop. That request goes to our router and through our modem, it goes out to the internet. The internet then finds that website that we're looking for. It returns the response to your modem and router, and then it gets returned to your device. Now, what happens if we have a Wi-Fi extender? You're basically just adding another link to the chain here. So your laptop sends the internet request to your Wi-Fi extender, and then your extender makes that same request on behalf of your device to your router and modem. It then goes out to the internet. It gets returned to your modem and router, sent back through your Wi-Fi extender, and then back to your laptop. Because of the natural setup of Wi-Fi extenders, your internet performance will suffer when your devices are connecting to the internet through your Wi-Fi extender. Part of the problem here is that this device is also operating on the same Wi-Fi channel as the rest of your devices. It's basically serving as another device in your home network, and it's communicating with your router. So you can imagine if you have a lot of devices in your home network, that are connecting to the internet through the Wi-Fi extender. This Wi-Fi extender is going to be very busy sending a bunch of requests to your router. Your router is going to be returning a bunch of requests to this device. And unfortunately, it can clog things up and it can slow down your internet connection. The bottom line is if you run a speed test, you're lucky to get about half of the internet speed that you get when connected through your router. Unfortunately, the knocks on Wi-Fi extenders don't stop there. Another knock on Wi-Fi extenders is that they don't really support seamless transitions from one Wi-Fi network to the next within your home. So let's say the Wi-Fi network from this device is named the same as the Wi-Fi network that your router is broadcasting. Let's say your device is connected to your router. You walk far away from it, so you get a weaker Wi-Fi signal, and you have a stronger Wi-Fi signal with your Wi-Fi extender. Unfortunately, just by the nature of how these devices communicate, your device will try to maintain that connection with your router instead of automatically switching over to that Wi-Fi extender. If you try to combat this by changing the Wi-Fi network of your Wi-Fi extender to something that's different than the Wi-Fi network broadcast from your router, then you find yourself manually switching between Wi-Fi networks all the time, which can get annoying if you're doing this frequently. So is it all bad news when it comes to Wi-Fi extenders? Should we just pack it up and never buy one of these devices? Well, actually, there's some good news here, and that's because there are new features that are being rolled out with the newer Wi-Fi extenders. What I mean by this, for example, as you can see here, there's an Ethernet port on the side of the device. What this allows you to do is it allows you to put the device in access point mode. This essentially lets you connect your router and your Wi-Fi extender with an Ethernet cable. And what this does is it removes all these limitations that a Wi-Fi extender experiences. You don't have any bandwidth limitations. You can basically use your Wi-Fi extender as a second router in your home. It broadcasts the same Wi-Fi network that your router does, and you can deploy it wherever you need a Wi-Fi signal as long as the extender is connected to your router with an Ethernet cable. If, for example, your router and your Wi-Fi extender are made from the same manufacturer, for example, my router is made by TP-Link, my Wi-Fi extender is made by TP-Link, if both of these devices support mesh Wi-Fi network capabilities, then it's possible that this Wi-Fi extender can simply be used as a mesh Wi-Fi access point in your home network. What this means is that this device can wirelessly communicate with your router, and you don't have to deal with any of those bandwidth limitations that you experience when this is in regular Wi-Fi extender mode. It's important to do your research before making any purchasing decisions. You need to verify that both your router and your Wi-Fi extender support this mesh Wi-Fi capability. You can find this on your manufacturer's website. It will usually tell you which devices have this enabled. So who should buy a Wi-Fi extender? Well, if you can't use it in mesh Wi-Fi or access point mode, the use cases become fewer and further between. With that said, there are still use cases for these devices if you can only use them in Wi-Fi extender mode. For example, in the garage of my home, it's currently a dead zone for my Wi-Fi network that's broadcast from my router. And I know that in that area, I only use the internet to surf the web, to stream some music occasionally, and once in a while, I'll be pulling up a YouTube how-to video. Because I know that I'll only have one internet device connected through my Wi-Fi extender at a given time, even with the limited bandwidth, it's still plenty for me to do these basic internet tasks. So even though with a Wi-Fi extender, you might be getting less bandwidth, that still might be plenty for what you need to do in that given current dead zone in your home. If you have multiple devices that are just browsing the internet, answering email, streaming music, and doing low internet bandwidth tasks, you can probably use more than one connected device through your Wi-Fi extender. I previously made another video detailing what internet activities require what bandwidth from the internet, and this is very important from a planning perspective. Before you go out and you make any purchasing decisions, try to get an idea of how much bandwidth you need in that given area. On the other hand, if you have multiple devices that need to stream ultra high definition video, or you want to competitively game, I wouldn't recommend a Wi-Fi extender unless you can implement it in access point or mesh mode. What I would recommend doing in these cases is looking into either a separate Wi-Fi access point or implementing a brand new mesh system in your home. These devices are more expensive, but you don't have to worry about the same performance limitations that you get with a Wi-Fi extender if you can't implement it in mesh or access point mode. If you have a Wi-Fi extender in your home, I'd love to see in the comments section what performance you're getting and what devices and internet activities you're carrying out through the Wi-Fi extender. As always, thanks for watching this episode from Network from Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.